tonight with this new information about a grass fire that broke out this morning in Pueblo. Fire crews say they responded to Fountain Creek near 29th and Dillon Drive this morning. They say that blaze started near a homeless camp and burned about 4 acres. 11 News reporter Caitlin Quisenberry joins me now in studio. Caitlin, you actually spoke with a man who says he was there and helped people get out of the area to safety.
Grace, Jacob Handler says he was just driving by on I-25 with his family when he saw smoke. Feeling compelled, he pulled over and faced the flames himself.
Doing everything we could towards the river, just try to save stuff and tanks. And yeah, it was like a war zone, not gonna lie. It was like being in combat.
Pueblo Fire Department says they first responded to the scene around 9:30 this morning. Strong wind conditions made fire containment difficult, but crews said they were able to get the fire mostly contained by 1:30 this afternoon. Crews say the fire has burned close to 4 acres. Evacuations were not ordered for the fire due to the crew's quick response, helping deter flames from nearby homes. But unofficial evacuations were yelled out by those living in the homeless encampment.
There was a man that was still in a tent they kept yelling for, and we turned around and the whole camp was in flames.
Jacob Handler tells me he estimated about 25 to 30 people were living in the encampment. His first rescue was a family. He says if it hadn't been for him, the family would not have left.
Quickly coaxed him into leaving. As soon as the flames hit the campground, they kind of, took off running for shelter. And I navigated them through the smoke, carried some of the things, took someone else out, outside perspective, tell them that their life's more valuable than that.
Handler is experiencing homelessness himself and expressed frustration for the lack of care given to this community.
They got to stay warm. How else do you expect them to stay warm? There's a part of society that's lacking the proper help and resources to better them from having to live in situations such as that. Was one of the biggest fire traps that you can imagine.
Handler wasn't sure of just how many people made it out of the flames, but he says he kept turning back to keep evacuating person after person. There has not been any reported injuries or hospitalizations. The cause of the fire is still under investigation. Grace, back to you.
Happy to hear that there was no injuries. Thank you, Caitlin.